like to discuss possibility of motion picture starring you both. Regards, Mordicus.
What I'm doing.
I know, but let's just go out and see what it's all about.
No, you go ahead. I got some things to do. I'll meet you later.
Come on, bud. You don't have anything to do.
No, you go ahead. Besides, you know I hate business.
Not business. I'm just gonna go out and see what it's all about.
No, thank you.
Are you coming or not?
No, thank you.
Come on, bud. You don't have anything to do. You just don't want to go up and talk to the man.
No, thank you, please.
Know what you are?
What?
A pain.
I know it. See you later.
You in just a moment.
You may proceed. Splendid. Splendid. I'm really quite impressed. I'd like to hire this man.
Okay, you got him.
And please remove the debris.
Right, Mr. Mordicus, you heard him. Get money. Come on.
My dear Sonny, how good of you to come. I'm Mordicus.
Pleased to meet you.
Will your wife be joining us?
No, she couldn't make it. You just get half of the team today.
Oh, what a pity. I do so enjoy young people. It's one of my few pleasures. That's why I take time out occasionally from my other activities to produce motion pictures. Making money has all but lost its attraction for me. Actually, Sonny, I am a simple man. And therefore, my proposition is a simple one. I propose to produce a motion picture starring yourself and Cher.
Well, that's great. That's what we want to do.
Oh, fine. Then it's settled.
Well,
excuse me. No, no, no. No, there can be no extension on the loan. Please tell His Highness that they have exactly 24 hours to pay, or I shall be forced to foreclose. Well, those were the terms. But don't you see, Charles, that's the point. Why control a company when one can control an industry? Oh, yes, that's final. Small nations are such bad risks.
That's amazing.
But business bores me, Sonny. Motion pictures excite me. And I must confess that the prospect of making a motion picture with you and Cher is something that I find most exciting.
All right, here's the thing. We've had a lot of offers, but I would like to have something to say about the creative end of our first movie.
Yes. You must trust me. I know everything that there is to be known about you. But it wasn't until I saw this that I became convinced of your potential for the screen.
Oh, I remember that. That's the thing we did for television.
You're not the kind of guy that make the girls all sigh, and they never turn their heads and look when you walk by. But baby, that's okay. I love you anyway, and I've never changed or rearranged you, so stay that way, 'cause it's
sunning. Hold my hand and you got me going. Kiss my lips and my mind starts growing. You got a thing that won't stop cooking. You turn me on just by looking. You can make me strong just by sighing. You can break my heart just by crying.
Exciting, isn't it, seeing yourself on the screen?
But that was just a variety show. All we had to do was sing. I'd like to do a story.
Oh, yes, a story. An astute observation. We need a story, and we'll get one. Good one. The best. Mere detail, of course. Mere frosting on the cake, so to speak.
Mr. Mordicus, I'm sure you know what you're doing, but I think I could help if I could work with the writer.
My dear Sonny, I must speak frankly. To create the right kind of story, I must have the finest writer that money can buy. Now, have you ever written a motion picture script before?
No.
You see? Trust me. I propose a bargain. If the script is wrong, you may suggest changes. Even create your own setting if necessary. Would you accept under those terms?
Yeah, on those conditions, I'd accept, yes.
Fine. Then it's settled. The contracts will be drawn up this afternoon and sent to your managers for approval.
Okay, it was a pleasure meeting you.
Marilyn, will you show Sonny to the door? And please give my regards to Cher. I'm looking forward to meeting her.
I will. Thank you.
Let's have a look at that script.
Yes, sir.
That's what all this needs is a new cover. Maybe add a few pages. And put their names on it in gold.
you, Sally.
On my table, she has to design a new clothes.
Don't yell at me. Yell at her. She's the one that's...
You're her husband. You yell at her.
Hi, hon.
Cher, why? Why do you always have to draw on the man's tabletop?
Honey, that's okay. You can just pay him a little extra.
That's not the point, sweetheart. The point is, he always yells at me instead of you. You get away with it, and that's why you do it.
Okay.
Okay, what? Okay, you won't do it anymore, or okay, you're pacifying me?
Okay, I won't do it anymore.
Oh, good. That's 16 times now you promised me that.
How's your meeting?
Good. We're gonna make a movie.
I really hope you know what you're doing.
I know what I'm doing. Don't worry.
Pow, pow.
Hey! Partner. Come here.
Hi.
What are you doing?
Playing cowboys and Indians.
Oh, yeah? How would you like it if I played cowboys and Indians with your wife?
I haven't got a wife.
Oh, you're not married yet, huh? What are you supposed to be right now?
A cowboy.
A cowboy? Cowboy doesn't wear his guns like that. Come here. Let me show you how a cowboy wears his gun. Now you can draw. Try it. Better?
Yeah.
You want to draw on me?
Okay.
Okay. We'll draw on each other. Okay, stay there. When she counts to three, we'll draw.
All right, you guys ready?
Yeah.
Yep.
All right, one.
Hey, Cher, what do you think?
What do I think about what? Two.
About me as a cowboy. How do I look?
Ridiculous. Three.
Bang, bang!
West comes the mighty saga of one man's struggle to bring peace to a lawless frontier. Of all the legendary lawmen, one man sits tallest in the saddle. Irving Ringo, sheriff of Broken Elbow, Nebraska, the roughest town in the West. To enforce the law, he has nothing but raw courage and a fast gun. Here on the frontier, a man's reputation rests on a cool hand and a dead eye.
Say, Sheriff, need any bullets today?
Maybe I can use a few, yeah.
Okay. You know, I never seen any man use as many bullets as you do.
Ah, you know how it is in my business. Shot here, shot there. It all adds up.
Say, Sheriff, did you hear about Knife McBlade breaking jail last week?
Last week? Knife McBlade?
Yeah. You think he'll come gunning for you for sending him up?
Let him come. I'm ready for him.
Say, Sheriff, I never seen anybody wear his gun like you do.
Quickest way to fire a shot. Throw a can over there. I'll show you what I mean.
A what?
Throw a can out there.
Oh, a can. Yeah, sure.
Okay, now stand back. See what I mean? Come on, Rover. See that, Rover? You gotta be tough and hard. You just wait outside. I'll be right back. Going in for a bowl of chili. Stay there.
They ever hear tell of the fastest gun in the West?
And the toughest man in the West.
Mm-hmm. That's right, stranger.
That's Irving Ringo.
Sheriff of this here town.
You know, it's so tough to name.
The last critter that said that to Ringo felt 30 pieces of lead before he could get his gun out.
Darn near killed him.
Irving Ringo don't know the meaning of the word fear.
Maybe it's about time for some learning, huh? Pass me.
Buddy.
Name's Ringo, Irving Ringo.
I don't think it is. I think it's Mud. Irving Mud.
It's Ringo, Irving Ringo.
How's the chili?
Not that good. Something missing in it today, I don't know.
Maybe it's Tabasco sauce.
You shouldn't have done that, stranger. Knock that off. The nerve, did you? Cross that line. The nerve, huh?
Oh, I got a six gun here that says you're yellow.
Oh, where's it say there?
And a trigger finger just itching to prove it.
I gave him every chance.
Oh, look at that.
Say, you got a bottle of breaks? You had enough? Oh. Hey, that's it. That's what was missing. Oh, and stay out! Bubby.
Oh.
Sheriff, to you, mister. Didn't you just see what I...
Howdy, howdy,
sorry about that, ma'am. You know, I'd like to get to know you better.
Oh, oh, oh.
Well, I was born in a log cabin. No, no, I mean really get to know you, Irv.
Oh, get to know her! Get to know her!
See, they like you. Nice time to show your appreciation. Right, boys?
Yeah.
Why don't you sing them a song?
Oh.
Shucks, ma'am, I can't sing. Don't let that stop you. If you think you got trouble, I knew a girl named Bubbles. She did a dance she called the Bear Dive. Ain't that nice? One night she did a dance, she had him in a trance. Till some wise guy brought a safety pin. Now she wears a grin.
Right on, right on, young merry-go-round. Don't be afraid, cause it won't break down. Dance and sing and raise your glass. Drink to the good times and hope, my friend, that they last. So take from me, because it's free. Just you remember, friend, to find that happy end, to find a pot of gold where rainbows shine. You got to take the time to ride on. Time.
'cause it's free. Just you remember, friend, to find a happy end, to find a pot of gold where rainbows shine. You got to take the time to ride.
For you. Knife McBlade and his brothers are coming in on the 247 stage.
Everyone, you scared?
Nah, I ain't afraid. Not while I know how to use this.
Did you hurt yourself?
Nah, it's nothing. Nothing. All right, all my deputies up here. Luke, Sam, Pete, come on.
Come on, you guys. You're the sheriff. Get up there.
Luke, Sam, Pete, all my deputies, come on up here. I'll tell you how we're gonna handle this thing.
Irving, my boy, I've got a wife and five hungry kids at home.
Tough luck, Irving.
Well, I'm awful sorry, Mr. Irvin, but I'd like to have a wife and five hungry kids someday.
Sorry, Herb. I've got bad eyes.
Those are the brakes, kid.
It's my gun hand. It's my gun hand's going bad. My gun hand. I'm sorry. Really.
Terribly sorry, Sheriff. I've got a pass.
I'm sorry, Herb. When you swore me in, I said I'd never do nothing like this. I ain't got no guts.
Cry, baby.
I didn't want to be a deputy anyway, Irving.
Why don't you make her a deputy?
Good luck, Irving.
Too bad, Irv.
Too bad.
Yeah, good luck.
Good luck.
Thank you.
Did he get me?
Afraid so, pal. What kind of a cowboy do you think you'd make now?
Not that good, I guess. Here's your gun, kid.
See ya, Sheriff.
Just a dog. You're just a little P-U-P dog. Now, come on. It's delicious. You'll love it. Just try it one time. Everybody's a critic today. Here. Okay, let's settle this like men. Follow me. A three-year-old dog is going to criticize my sauce. Cher, I need some help, sweetheart.
I'm still not talking to you.
Oh, bud, look. I brought you a present.
I don't want your present. And take off that hat. You look ridiculous.
Come on, bud. We shouldn't fight in front of our fans.
What do you mean, in front of what fans?
Scoonji.
You're not funny, Sonny. And you're ridiculous, and I don't want you riding a motorcycle.
Sure, I'm just gonna ride it on the side streets, and besides, I look sexy on it. Now, will you please tell me where you put the keys?
Sonny, I'm not telling you where I put the keys, and if you want to look sexy, buy yourself a bikini.
Oh, bud, look. Here. How's that?
What about it?
What do you think of it?
It's okay, why?
Because I'm having an argument with Scoonji and he doesn't think it's that great.
He should argue with you. You're bad for buying a motorcycle without me knowing it.
Oh, come on, bud. Don't be like that now. Say, this is lovely. When did you do it?
Saturday. Why don't you take off that hat? You look like an idiot.
I'm gonna paint your name on it.
I don't care. Why don't you work on your little movie?
Tell you what. Tell me where you put the keys, and I'll give you my own, very favorite statue.
I don't care. I don't want your favorite statue. I hate that statue more than I hate your motorcycle because I think it looks like Mr. Mortimer.
His name is Mordicus, and you know it. How do you know what he looks like? You never seen him before.
Good. I don't want to.
Yeah, just for that, I'm not gonna let you meet him.
Big deal. I'm crushed.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Well, don't ask to meet him, then.
Okay, I won't.
Don't think this argument's over just because I've been interrupted. Hi.
Mr. Mordicus requests your presence.
Mordicus wants to see me now?
Mr. Mordicus regrets the inconvenience and begs your indulgence.
Okay, I'll come.
Mr. Mordicus also requests the presence of your wife.
Oh, boy, you couldn't pick a better time for that. Let me see. Hold on.
How would you like to meet Mr. Mordicus?
You gotta be kidding. After that big speech you just gave me, who's out there?
Warren.
Who's Warren?
He's kind of like Mr. Mordicus's right-hand man.
What does he want?
Wants us to go see Mr. Mordicus.
Let Mr. Mordicus come and see us.
Sure he can. His time is more involved than ours. Do you want to come or not?
All right, I'll do it for you, but I don't like it.
You don't like what?
I don't like this whole situation. I think you're bending.
What does that mean?
I don't know, but we'll see.
Wild, huh?
Where are the bat poles?
Come on, cool it.
No, really, I have to find the bathroom.
Will you cut it out? Boy, this is really wild.
These are not the clouds I ordered. This entire sky is wrong. Absolutely unacceptable. You may strike this sky. I've finished with it.
Yes, sir. Atrocious sky, Mr. M.
Hi, Sonny.
How are you?
You must be Cher.
Hello.
Cher, Mr. Mordicus.
What was wrong with the sky?
That's a delightful outfit you're wearing, my dear. I understand you design your own theme.
Yes.
Let me have the
come
kids
on,
just right up.
Come on.
Come on.
Here we go. One shot.
Get him in here.
This time we go.
This nose will have to go.
I was
Cher, is it true you design all the
clothes? Yes.
Are the sets under construction?
Everything moving, Chief.
Casting completed?
Ready to roll in a week, sir.
Well, then we're right on schedule. Now, that's about enough of all that.
Right, sir.
Let's have it quiet on the set, please. Now, we're going to have a press conference in Mr. Mordicus's office in about an hour. All you folks from radio, television, and the press will be taken care of then. You'll meet Sonny and Cher and talk to them. The rest of you folks, we want to clear this stage. You understand? We want no one on here. Sylvan, lock that door.
All right,
now,
you
please, ladies and gentlemen, if you will.
Clear the set, please. Come on, everybody out.
Mr. Goff?
Good morning, Mr. M. We're in great shape. This thing is a gas.
Sonny and Cher, your writer, Leslie Goff.
Hi.
How are you?
Nice to meet you. You're going to love this.
Now then. Yes, seems about right, wouldn't you say, Warren?
Yes, it feels about like 90 minutes, give or take an hour or two, sir.
Perfect. Production will begin in 10 days. Warren, tell Wardrop to move right ahead.
I didn't think we were going to start that soon.
Time is of the essence, Sonny. This picture must be in release before the end of summer.
Well, what's the delay? Everything's set.
Yeah, but you said if I didn't like the story, I could make some changes.
Yes. You have a point. I suggest a compromise. Mr. Garth will tell us the story in capsule form. All else is embellishment.
Right, sir.
As we've agreed, it's the story that's important.
Okay, fine. I'd like to hear the story.
Mr. Garth?
We open... We open big, see? Steam shovels, derricks, bulldozers, all plowing up the earth. Lots of noise. It's progress, see? Symbolic.
Just the story, Mr. Garth, briefly.
Sure, sure. Get into it, Mr. M. Now, there's this boy and girl, see? Nice kids, but nowhere. Slobs. They live in hillbilly country, you dig? And they sing. They even made a hillbilly record, only it never sold. Real tapped-out cats. No bread in the bank, none in the house, and not much house. Solid poverty, dig? And that way we grab sympathy for them right off the top. You're rooting for them. We keep laying in that misery real good till you're crying, you know? Real tough times, like they starve from no food. The still won't work. A neighbor steals their mule. There won't be a dry eye in the house. And when you think things can't get any worse, they do. The anti-poverty people are coming through. They want to put up a housing development. They want to relocate them. Now, most cats would jump at the chance, but not our kids. No, they love their house. Even though it's a rat hole, they want to hang on to it. Individualism, dig? Why, they'd rather stay slobs than let the government own them. But the government's coming on strong, and our kids look like sure losers when, bam, another miracle. I mean, right out of the blue. One night, this jockey gets bombed, the local guy, see? And he plays their record by mistake. And all of a sudden, they're a smash. The hit of the world, eh? Now, for a real upbeat ending, the kids zoom to the top, see? Nothing but loot. But they're all heart. I mean, they're real. Now, get this for a twist, will you? At the finish, the kids hire a big-time lawyer, and he searches the records and finds a loophole, and the government can't buy the house. Now, the kids put a lot of money into it and turn it into a monument to hillbilly music. I mean, is that great? I mean, can you feel it? I mean, is that custom-made?
I don't want to hurt anybody's feelings, but, well, this story might be great for somebody else, but it isn't something we could do.
Well, what didn't you like about it?
Well, it's just, this is something we couldn't do.
You just can't
now,
do
now,
it.
Please,
why?
Mr. Garth, don't get emotional. Writers are so sensitive.
I write a great ending and she breaks up. Mr. M, you said this thing was all wrapped up. All we had to do was...
It's a little work, but it's basically sound. Tried and true theme, rags to riches, works every time. Perhaps it loses something in the telling.
It's solid, Mr. M, solid. Taylor and Burton would do it in a minute.
No doubt.
Mr. Mordicus, I'm telling you now, there's no way we can do that story.
Oh. Well, our contract calls for a picture. Not necessarily this one.
But we must begin in 10 days. You have until then to create your own vehicle. And please feel free to call upon Mr. Garth for any assistance that you might require.
10 days?
For a genius, 10 days is an eternity. The world was created in 7. You have 3 extra days. And all of this to work with. Make of it what you will.
It's kind of exciting, isn't it?
Yeah.
Hey, that's a yeah that doesn't mean yeah at all. What's the matter, bud?
Oh, I don't know, son. Are you sure you want to get mixed up with those creeps?
So he's a little weird. Listen, he ought to know what he's doing, Cherry. He owns half of the world.
Yeah, and I think he wants to own you, too.
Have I ever steered you wrong yet?
No.
Well?
Well, I'm not going to be a poverty-stricken whatever it is I'm supposed to be.
Hey, you. Would I let him do that to us? Trust me. All you gotta do is trust me. All you gotta know is everywhere I go, everything I do it just for you, so trust me. Trust me. Cause I need you more than I've ever needed you before.
Hey, my friend, I don't know where you are, but I'll be there, I'll help you find your star. There's not a face can take your place by far.
Across a stormy sea, a captain so brave he's feared by all his crew. That's what I'll be. How about you? I'd like to ride upon a merry-go-round and be all dressed up just like a circus clown. I'd hold up a hula hoop and you could jump through. That's what I'll be. How about you? There are a million things I want to be, like sailing a ship across a stormy sea, a
a captain so brave he's feared by all his crew. That's what I'll be. How about you?
How did I ever wind up with somebody like you?
I don't know, just lucky, I guess.
Well, tell me something. What are you supposed to be right now?
I'm Aladdin's lamp.
You're the son of Aladdin's lamp.
I'm a magician.
Oh, yeah? Well, I'm Snow White.
Hey, Cher. Cher, I got it. I'm king of the jungle.
Boy, are you clumsy. That's the fourth time today.
So I lost my balance.
How can you lose what you never had?
Listen, that's no way to talk to Jungle Maury, king of the jungle, ruler of all...
Will you stop that king of the jungle jazz? You're a grown man.
Oh, yeah? You want to hear something?
No, please. You can be the king or the prince or anything. Just don't let go with one of those awful yells.
Who says it's awful?
Everybody in the world.
Besides them, who?
Besides them, we got to get going. What time is it?
I'll tell you what time it is.
So what time is it?
It's 11 o'clock.
Well, there you are, folks. Take a look at that great wash job. Now, Buona, I've got a deal for you.
Not Buona, me, Maury, Jungle Maury, king of the jungle. I was brought up by apes. I'm the only man who can talk to animals.
You put me on.
Oh, you don't believe me, huh?
Please, believe him.
Listen.
Believe him.
Very nice.
Thank you. How much for the wash?
That'll be three fish.
That sounds like a lion.
Good thinking.
Don't worry, Zora, I'll save you.
Please, do me a favor. Don't save me.
I gotta save you, or I wouldn't be Jungle Maury, king of the jungle.
Will you leave the poor thing alone? He's tired of wrestling you every day for crying
out
loud.
Don't panic, Zora, don't panic. I'll get him. Gawa.
Get this thing over with. Maury, please, leave him alone.
Beat it. This is your lucky day. For dinner.
I thought we called Jungle Delight.
Jungle Delight? What do you do all day? I can't get a home-cooked meal.
Look, you knew when you met me I wasn't the domestic type.
Forget the one-liners, will you? Just get my robe. Jungle Delight. I hate it.
color. The exciting adventures of Jungle Gino.
Zar, Zar, come here, quick!
What's the matter? What's wrong?
What's wrong? It's that fake again. That phony.
Oh,
that imposter. I got a good mind to sue him.
Oh, Maury, will you forget it? Just relax.
They look at you one time. He's not even using a real vine.
Now in a secret underwater cave,
Jungle Gino
managed to send a message to his faithful monkey, Jerome. We look in now as faithful monkey Jerome attempts to chew through the ropes that...
Where's my faithful companion, Pizza?
How am I supposed to know? He said he was going for a walk.
A walk? Where's he got to walk to?
Oh, Jungle Gino, you underestimate my power.
Pizza! Pizza!
Read 'em and weep, baby. The dice are mine today. There, that's the rent. Now for the groceries.
Pizza!
Oh, man, what's that cat want now?
Ooh, what a...
Oh, come to me, green stuff.
Shut up and shoot.
Coming out.
Sheesh. Oh, this 28 is... straight passes. This is incroyable.
How about that? Okay, the point's eight. Eight of from the cater. Coming out. I can't stand it.
What is this?
Those are new dice.
And the loaded.
Hey, you guys are sore losers.
You always win because you cheat.
I'm going to belt somebody.
Stand back, you big baboon.
I'll belt you right in the mouth.
Who got it? What are you hitting me for?
He's one of my dearest friends. How often do I get to see him? Hiya, Pizza. Play a little checkers.
Stupid.
Look, if you're gonna watch a game, don't kibitz.
Boy, you know, that's the stupidest thing you've done all day.
What do you mean? I told you, I don't want animals in this house.
Sore loser.
I can't concentrate when somebody watches every move I make.
Listen, Maury, I want you to have a talk with the kid. You know, he's still hanging out with that bad crowd.
Don't worry. It's just a stage he's going through.
Yeah, and you never pay him any attention. At least you can talk to him once in a while.
Hi, kid. How you doing, kid?
I don't mean yell out the window. I mean go down and have a talk with him.
Boy, you nag.
I'll give you a nag.
How you doing, boy, huh? How you coming with that dugout canoe? Got it finished yet, kid?
It's about half done. How do you like it?
That's a nice thing, boy. Boy, the school asked me to talk to you about your hair. Why do you have to wear it so short?
It's a fad. Everybody's wearing their
hair
shorter.
Yeah, but boy, it doesn't look good. It doesn't look clean. It looks like you're rebelling against something. Ah, boy. Boy, what's gonna become of you, huh?
Don't worry, J.M. It's just a stage I'm going through.
What is that? What is it?
Boy, there's a message for you. I think it's urgent.
Thank you.
There it is. At last. The elephant's graveyard. Enough ivory to bring untold riches. And it's all mine. All right, men. Move in and take it.
Yeah! Turn back! Only elephants allowed in elephant's graveyard.
Out of my way, clown.
Not clown. Jungle Mori, king of the jungle. I was brought up by the apes. I'm the only man that can talk to the animals. Now what do you think?
Out of my way or I'll be forced to dispose of you.
You don't understand. All I gotta do is yell out there one time, and every animal in this jungle will come running. It's worse than the freeway. You'll get trampled.
I detest violence, but you leave me no alternative. Gentlemen!
All right, don't say I didn't warn you. Don't say I didn't warn you.
Son.
Zora is a very important lady in my life.
She's not going to have any life if you don't tell me who she is.
Tell you what, you tell me where you put my motorcycle keys and I'll tell you who Zora is.
Make a better deal. I won't break that statue over your head if you tell me who she is.
All right, I dreamt I was Jungle Mori and you were his girl companion, Zora, and we lived off the fat of the jungle.
Well, why'd you have to pick a name like Zora?
I didn't. It came with the dream.
Where are you going?
I'm just gonna check the bike. I'll be right back.
Well, what am I supposed to do?
I'll be right back.
Thank you. what I see. Someday your dreams will all come true, but watch who you run to, 'cause you gotta be free. Don't talk to strangers, baby. Watch out for
Scrunch. You wanna watch some TV? Look, it's your favorite program.
Tonight's exciting episode, the green peppermint stick of
battle. I don't believe you two. Why don't you give him his own car?
Anything you say. Scrunchy thinks you should be a detective.
I don't want to be a detective.
He thinks you'd make a great detective.
How does Scrunchy know what kind of a detective I'd make?
Because he thinks you can do anything.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
So far out, it might work. Wouldn't that be wild? Me, a private eye. All I'd have to do is learn how to sneer. Why not? I got the looks for it. Been a tough day. Exciting but tough. In this business, they all are. The name's Pizzicato. Johnny Pizzicato, private eye. It was 8:15, maybe 8:20, possibly 8:40. With a cheap watch, you can't tell. You and mister.
I came here to warn you, but what if the Ruthian's killers followed me? You'll be here any second. What do you think?
I think you ought to knock next time he comes through that door.
There was no time. He's after you, but now he'll kill me because I know what they're up to. And if he kills me, they'll still be after you, only then I won't be able to tell you what they're up to.
You mind repeating that, baby?
There's no time, no time.
Why not? It's only 8:15. Maybe 8:20.
Please, please.
Possibly 8:40. All right, wait in there. I'll handle this.
Pizzicato.
Mr. Pizzicato, baby cakes. Should I know? I only met her today.
Save me, Johnny, save me!
That's my third window this week.
Oh, you saved me!
All right, baby, what's this all about?
The Ruthie and the crime lord, he put...
That can really be painful.
Decisions, all day decisions.
Good evening, Mr. Pitsy.
Hello, Johnny. I called you last night.
Don't call me. I'll call you Frog Legs.
Yes?
Got a table in the main room, baby cakes?
Reservations only.
Got a table in the main room, baby cakes?
I feel like I can squeeze you in. Yes, gentlemen.
You got a table in the main room?
I'll see what I can do. Step this way, gentlemen.
You ought to give up smoking.
Thought of getting into some other kind of work.
Man's got to stick to the work he knows best.
That's what I mean. This private eye stuff is getting us nowhere.
Look, Sam, I told you 100 times. Next case I saw, bang, we get married.
That's what I mean. You told me 100 times.
What's a hurry, Sam? You're only 19.
Yeah, but we've been engaged 7 years. People are beginning to talk.
Not as much as they talked when we first got engaged. Maybe you're right. Maybe I ought to get into some other racket.
No, you'll never be happy. It's in your blood. You spent too many years in the force.
Yeah, I was the best, too.
Why'd they kick you off?
I still think the police commissioner was behind it.
Yeah, but he's your uncle.
Politics, it can happen to anybody.
Come on, we'll get him outside.
Looks like I gotta go to work, Sam. Don't go away.
Kicked off the force.
Excellent, gentlemen. You've captured Pizzicato.
What do you need with this bum, boss?
Why should I bother with an unemployed private detective?
You already control all the crime in the city.
Quite, but the police commissioner has proved annoying lately. He must be disposed of. He's Pizzicato's uncle, therefore I shall use Pizzicato as the man to kill him.
Hey, that's smart, boss.
Don't interrupt. Now, then. Can you hear me, Pizzicato?
I hear you.
You will obey my every word.
I will obey your every word.
He is completely hypnotized. He will do precisely as I instruct. The tough Mr. Pizzicato is now reduced to a babe in arms.
Da-da.
Now then, all I have to do is to send him into police headquarters carrying this bomb, tuned to go off at the sound of a phone in the interrogation room, and in 1 hour the police commissioner will be blown to bits.
Yeah, but boss, what if nobody dials that number?
We'll make sure of that ourselves.
Oh, yeah, that's creative.
What a moxie, boss.
And the best part of it is that the police commissioner's own nephew will be solely responsible.
Be a good girl, Sam. Tell me, where is Pizzicato?
You really want to know, Lieutenant?
Oh, for 2 hours I've been asking you questions. The commissioner's in his office getting ready to fire me, and you ask me, do I really want to know? No, of course not.
All right, I won't tell you.
Of course I want to know!
He's right behind you.
I knew where he was all the time.
Johnny, what's the matter? Are you okay?
Da-da.
It does look a little funny. And do you feel all right?
Da-da.
I better call the commissioner and tell him I captured Pizzicato.
Come on, Johnny, sit down.
Boss, the line is busy.
Try it again.
I know he's entitled to one phone call, but he's been on that phone for 20 minutes and he hasn't said a word.
So he's a good listener.
Would you hang up that phone before I go to pieces?
Boss, it's ringing. It's ringing. This is it.
Schlemmer's Delicatessen, corned beef, roast beef, and pastrami. Your order, please.
Incompetent fool.
Another minute of this and I'll really blow up.
I got it. It's ringing.
Hello.
We're going to hear the explosion. The bomb is...
Way to say hello.
It's just Cerulean's headquarters exploding into action.
Johnny!
Just Cerulean's headquarters? Where is he? Where can I find him?
By now, several places. It depends on which part of him you want to find.
Johnny, you're all right.
Sure, I'm all right. I must have been hypnotized, but I slept it off.
Johnny, you're going to tell me what happened, or I'm going to lock you up and throw that key away.
It's simple, Lieutenant. Cerulean hypnotized me, placed a bomb in my pocket, tuned to go off when that phone rang. But he didn't know that before he hypnotized me, I overheard his plan, managed to switch the box containing the bomb with an identical box they had at their headquarters. So, Cerulean wound up placing this box in my pocket while the one with the bomb was left there to explode when the sound of your phone ring came through the receiver of their phone. You got it?
Yeah, and I'd like to give it back to you.
Look, Lieutenant...
Please, not again. As long as the diabolic Cerulean is done for and we're safe, that's all that counts.
See you later, Lieutenant. Come on, Sam.
By the way, Johnny, what's in that box? It looks like a radio.
I don't know and I don't care, as long as the bomb's in the other one. Here's a present for you, Lieutenant.
We must begin in 10 days. You have until then to create your own vehicle. The world was created in 7. I'm giving you 3 extra days and all of this to work with.
Thank you.
you.
We need a signature also.
Come empty-handed.
No, I can come up with something. I got some good ideas. All I need is a couple more days.
Only ideas? Nothing concrete? No script? And we shoot tomorrow at dawn.
I got more than ideas. I got a couple funny characters and some good situations.
Your naivete amuses me. We shoot tomorrow.
I can't shoot tomorrow.
Well, now, don't tell me you have stage fright.
No, I don't have stage fright. You got a bad script, and we can't do it.
I see. Well, I'm afraid I have no time for bickering. I have a script. You have a contract. Now, be on the set tomorrow at 6:30 a.m. for makeup.
What if I don't show up?
You force me to be unkind. If you don't show up, you will both be taken with a permanent case of laryngitis. There will be writs, restraining orders, and injunctions. You will not record or perform in any way until this contract has been fulfilled. And the contract calls for you to appear as rustic wonders in this delightful tour de force.
Look, Mr. Mordicus, let me ask you something. Let me buy my contract back.
Out of the question. We will make this picture. It will make money. And that, my boy, is what it's all about. Now, go and get some rest. You have a 6:30 call tomorrow morning.
Play like that when you're depressed.
I'm a little depressed, yeah.
Well, what's the matter, honey?
I don't know how to tell you.
What?
We gotta make that movie.
You mean we gotta make that rags to riches junk?
Yeah.
You said we didn't have to, son.
Well, we do.
And that's all you got to say? You're just gonna let him tell us what to do now?
That's not it. We got a contract. Don't you understand? It's either that or we're in a lot of trouble. You know nothing about business.
I don't care anything about business. I just care what you said, and you said we wouldn't have to do it. I told you not to get involved with those people.
Now I get I told you so, right? Okay, I did it and we goofed, okay? I'm sorry. What else? Now that's it. I don't want to hear about it anymore. Please, okay?
What can I say? You know you can't do this to yourself.
Just leave me alone. Really, get out! Get out of here! Get out!
Okay.
Can I have the keys to my bike, please?
Yes.
Just a name. It's just a name. It's not too long, and it's kind of plain. He's just a guy, just a little guy, and he's not too brave, not too shy. And he'll never make history, and he's not very much, of a mystery. He's not even handsome, nor is he tall, but there is no way I could live at all without his funny name. Just a guy, just a little guy that can make me laugh, that can make me cry. If I haven't mentioned this before, he's got all I want and even more, 'cause he gives me all that he has to give, and I guess that's why I just live without his funny name.
Chief, they'll eat it up.
With a script like this, how could it miss, huh? This will be the biggest grosser since Out of Sight. Why, Chief, we...
Right. Here they come, sir.
Morning.
Morning, Mr. Mordicus.
I admire promptness, but where is your lovely co-star?
She's not coming. I came here to tell you we're not going to make this picture.
You will go to work this morning, or your career is at an end.
Then my career is going to have to end.
Bravo. Excellent performance. Maybe Mr. Garth can work it into the script.
Maybe he can.
We're ready to roll, sir. What are you going to do?
What's to do? Huh? We'll get the next teenage idol that comes down the pike. There's hundreds of them.
Don't be uncouth, Mr. Garth.
Shall I get your attorney on the phone, sir?
No. Forget it.
Still want to make a movie?
They say we're young and we don't know. Won't find out until we grow. Then put your little got you, babe. I got you, babe. I got you, babe.